I'm 32 now, and over the last years, I've gotten really good at something. Well, really, I've gotten good at picking the things I'm good at and just doing those. I get the suspicion that I'm a decent engineer, so I spend some time writing programs and building things. And maybe more to the point, during the winter I ski, because I'm good at it. I don't snowboard, well, one, because I don't really like snowboarders, but two, because I'm pretty good at skiing, and I'd rather spend my time on the mountain doing something I'm pretty competent at, rather than spending the day wishing I was skiing the glades, and instead breaking my wrist on the bunny slopes. Anyway, this whole pandemic thing really changed how I got exercise. In March of 2020, I bought a turbo trainer for my bike, and I started using Trainer Road with it. The concept was easy. 3 times a week, I show up on the trainer and try as hard as I can. It tells me what to do, and I do it. I went along with this, and I got pretty strong, until the world started to open up, and some of my friends suggested that I ought to try out racing my bike. I started off trying my hand at a crit, the early bird training series. I thought I was pretty strong, and I held on for, oh, say, 15 minutes, before I got dropped like a sack of bricks. What happened? I'd been building up fitness for a year and a half by then, and somehow everyone else was stronger than I was. It was a rude awakening. I'd expect it to be good. I looked at the video, and I did a lot of stupid things. I spent a lot of time in the wind when I didn't have to be. I didn't hold my line through corners. And I had to burn power to chase people down through the exits. It's kind of surprising that I lasted as long as I did, to be honest. Things went a little better for me at the Sea Otter Circuit Race. 13th out of 52 isn't half bad. I learned a lot about holding wheels and saving energy there. But the real test came at the end of this year, when I started racing cyclocross. Cyclocross is a blast. Well, my expectations got shattered at early birds. I came into this one with no expectations. I knew that cyclocross was skill intensive, and if I got away with anything, it would be because of my fitness, not because I was any good at it. My bike handling skills were bad. But somehow, I stayed on the bike when I needed to, and I was pleasantly surprised with the results in my first race, coming in about midfield, 29th out of 56. I did 5 more races over the course of the season. 2 in Santa Cruz, the Surf City races, 1 in Prunedale, Secret Squirrel back home in Boston, and the last race in the Bay Area Super Prestige Series at Stafford Lake. I learned to deal with a lot of different terrain over the course of the series.
Going up.
Some things improved over the course of the series.
Yeah, I passed someone.
Some things stayed the same, more or less.
Why am I braking?
And some things, well, some things got worse the more I practiced.
Where the fuck are the pedals?
In my last men's sea race at Stafford Lake, I ended up 20th out of 37. How could this be? How did I get worse over the course of the season? In the Bay Area Super Prestige Omnium, I locked in a 6th place result, though. Well, out of 8 people who had attended at least 4 races. Anyway, my first season is over now. The big realization that I've had is it's been a long time since I've done something that I, well, plain old suck shit. I'm definitely not God's gift to bike racing.
Oh god, I'm going down.
For my last race of the season, I did 1 more session, just to see how long I'd hold on in the men's B group at Stafford Lake. By the 5th minute of the race, the field had more or less walked away from me. It's humbling, you know. It's been a long time since I tried hard at something and still didn't pick it up. Maybe that's the thing where I only do things that I'm good at these days. Maybe I ought to do this more often. I'll see you out there next season. Take care.
Going down.